If you're taking mitochondrial supplements and you're still dealing with exhaustion, fatigue, and burnout, then this video is going to be for you. Look, learning how to boost your mitochondria, which as you know, are the power plants of your cell and or the energy factories. And it goes so much deeper than just taking these mitochondrial supplements. In this video, what I want to do is I want to explain why. Why it goes so much deeper than just taking mitochondrial supplements. And I really want to talk to you about cellular respiration and mitochondrial essentials, three of them that you are not aware of in order to finally get your energy sustained and boosted for good. So let's dig in. So let's talk mitochondrial 101. As you are probably aware, the mitochondria are the cellular generators of energy or the power plants to your cells. But what you're not aware of is the reason why you're still dealing with exhaustion and burnout and from preventing you from getting answers. But don't feel bad, because the reality is it's not taught in the medical school curriculum, and for that matter in the alternative schools curriculum either. And it's really absent from nutritional training and getting down to the nitty-gritty of energy production 101. And that's really the number one reason we go as a population to go see the doctor, is because we're exhausted and tired, and any chronic health condition revolves around an energy-based problem. You're not making enough energy. So this information can get rather technical. So what I want to do is keep it really high level and easy, as understandable as possible. So let's start with how energy is actually made. I'm sure you've heard of ATP, and that is the cellular unit of energy in our body. And scientists estimate that we need to produce so much ATP to power our cells on a daily basis that we need to generate our weight in pounds in ATP per day. Just to put it in perspective, it's estimated that you need about 1 billion ATP with every single heartbeat. So think about how much ATP you need to produce on a daily basis. And this is the reason you're so tired, and the reason why just taking the mitochondrial boosting supplements aren't working. And so what are those mitochondrial boosting supplements? Typically they're NAD, D-ribose, CoQ10, L-carnitine, a lot of other alpha-lipoic acid. These are considered mitochondrial nutrients and boosters. And while they may be effective, it's not until you actually understand how cellular respiration works at the cellular level. You've probably heard of ATP already, and that is the body's main energy or currency for energy. And it's estimated that your body requires to produce so much ATP on a daily basis that your weight in pounds is the amount of ATP we need to produce to sustain our energy. Just think, the human heartbeat can be anywhere between 60 to 80 beats per minute, requires 1 billion ATP to power that. So it's a tremendous workload that's required by your cells and your mitochondria. And really it comes down to three simple steps. The three simple steps are, first, taking the food in the air and combining that together to make water, to release and make water. When that happens, your body is able to take the ADP, which is adenosine diphosphate, which only has two phosphate groups, versus ATP, which has three phosphate groups. Anyways, it releases ADP into the three phosphate group, ATP. And then lastly, the third phase is, once that ATP is produced, your mitochondria can spill off a lot of radicals and hydrogens, and these elements are called free radicals. And in fact, I have another video, you can click on the link, that describes why the number one reason for low energy has to do with those free radicals being spilled off. But the third process really has to do with being able to clean that exhaust to minimize the amount of exhaust that's being discharged. And the first simple essential ingredient that I'm going to recommend is copper. And it really needs to be in its bioavailable form, because copper powers those three reactions. It helps you convert that hydrogen and oxygen into water. It helps to release the ADP into ATP. And it then helps to be able to clean the exhaust so that your body isn't spilling out these free radicals. And it's really important to get a really good, high quality copper these days, because the soils have been so depleted since the 1920s of our raw minerals and nutrients. Furthermore, we've practiced putting glyphosates and pesticides and Roundup, which really will chelate and burn out all those minerals and it can chelate copper to a pH of 1.0, which basically means there's nothing left. So we want to be careful that we are getting the optimal form. So some of the best sources would be animal proteins and beef liver and lamb and veal. Other really great sources are sesame seeds, cashews, sunflower seeds, shiitake mushrooms, grape leaves, spirulina, sun-dried tomatoes. In fact, I'll leave a link underneath this video description giving you a link to all the different food sources and the optimal forms with the most bioavailable copper in there. And bioavailable copper will be a very important term when we get to the second most important ingredient. But before I do that, if you're getting any value out of this video, make sure you go ahead and click like and subscribe so that you can get further information on boosting your energy. The second most important nutrient to power your mitochondria is going to be vitamin A. Now, vitamin A has been shown in the research as early as the 20s as being the superstar vitamin. And it's funny how vitamin D has taken over the crown. But my prediction is that vitamin A will take over the crown once information continues to get out there about the importance of vitamin A. But vitamin A, amongst very many important forms of biochemical energy that vitamin A does, vitamin A plays a very important role in your immune system, and it plays a very important role in getting your body's ability to utilize that copper and make it bioavailable. When we say bioavailable, it loads it into the carrier protein, and that carrier protein can use copper as a conductive current to be able to do very important things like combining the food you eat and the air you breathe into water, ATP, and cleaning the exhaust. So it's very important that we have vitamin A in order to load that copper into those carrier proteins. And the problem, and we'll create another video, is that if your vitamin D levels are too high, you're not going to be able to get that vitamin A so that you can load the copper into the transporting protein so that you can create energy, you can clear the exhaust, and you can do the things that you need to do. So anyways, really great sources of vitamin A are going to be the same sources of copper in the animal products, the beef liver. Cod liver is a fantastic source of vitamin A. But for vegan sources and alternatives, you have chives, grape leaves, parsley, things like that can really provide a great nourishment of vitamin A. And the last major nutrient that I would recommend is magnesium. In order for your body to go from that second stage of water being released and ADP converting into ATP, you release a lot of magnesium in that instance. So we recommend, of course, get your doctor's advice, magnesium in the magnitude of 5 to 10 milligrams per pound of body weight. So if that person weighs 200 pounds, somewhere in the 1,000 to 2,000 milligrams is typically the recommended dose. However, you need to make sure you work with a provider and look at your starting RBC magnesium and make sure that there's no other yellow flags. But with all of that being said, magnesium is very important in the form. Two forms that we like are the magnesium glycinate and the magnesium malate. They're considered mitochondrial supporting nutrients as well when they're in their malate form, and then the glycinate form can be calming and supportive for inhibition. So we tend to recommend that one at night. So to summarize, in order to boost your mitochondria and make sure that you're sustaining your energy, it's not just about the regular mitochondrial nutrients. It's about supporting all three phases in cellular respiration, which are dependent on bioavailable copper, vitamin A, and magnesium. If you want to find out what you're actually doing on a daily basis, even when you get these minerals balanced and you start supporting boosting your mitochondria for good, you're going to want to know if you're not doing these changes during the day, you can cause that body to create a lot of exhaust and you'd be 24/7. So just click on the link below so that you can watch what it is that you're doing on a daily basis. Until then, take care and we'll help you in your quest for energy production.
Hey there, I hope you're getting tremendous value out of our videos. If you are, make sure you like our videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel, turn on your alert buttons, and then check out the description below because I have a free masterclass that will teach you how to 10x your energy levels in the next 12 weeks and finally end your energy and exhaustion nightmare.